That was the chorus to Native Tongue, one of the singles off of Leesburg, Virginia-based rock band My Kid Brother's self-titled EP. My Kid Brother is made up of Christian Yonakis on vocals and guitar, Piano Whitman on keys and vocals, Sam Mathanis on drums, Dylan Zavopoulos on guitar, and Richard Smith on bass. There's a lot of Greek names there. I am really sorry if I mispronounced any of those. Anyway, after signing with Fearless Records in 2019, the band released their first EP in September of this year, and it's a wonderful collection of a half dozen songs. For their first EP, the songs sound really polished, and they're all catchy as hell. I linked up with the entire band, which is pretty cool as I normally just get to speak with one member for these interviews, but this is also why the audio isn't the best, but the content is good, I promise. Anyway, we talk about the formation of the band, the making of the EP, and they share a couple of fun stories about acid trips. Here's my chat with My Kid Brother. Standing in the sun-soaked street.
Sam, stop.
Hello.
Hey, how's it going?
Hey, how's it going?
Yep. Good, how are you?
Excellent. What's up?
We're doing well. It's just pretty slow morning so far, besides work-wise. And then we were just doing a couple of interviews and decided just to get together for it, just in case for all the content and stuff like that.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, this is cool. I hardly ever do it with the full band, so this is great.
That's awesome.
New. Firstly, big question that is on everyone's mind: how is your pandemic going?
I think it's getting better because we're just kind of figuring out what to do and how to do it.
Yeah. But it's Not the situation that we'd like to be having, but trying to make the best of it as best we can.
Right on. Did any of you pick up new hobbies or anything? I know a lot of people are baking or...
Mm-hmm. Straight up.
Dylan got a motorcycle.
Yeah, I bought a motorcycle yesterday.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
I was making bread for a while.
Yeah.
And then I made cheese, and my girlfriend was making cheese.
Christian was growing cheese.
I was growing my cheese garden. No, I had a garden in the backyard, and just little things like that.
Cool. And then, of course, you guys also released an EP during all of this, which is very unique and must have been like a pretty tough pill to swallow, right? To figure out if, like, this, should we do it now? Should we wait? Like, what do we do?
Definitely had to rework our plan of action on it a good bit, but it's finally out there. And
how long have you guys all been together, like, in person? Did you have to take a break, like everyone, and kind of, quarantine yourselves? And
well, we all live together, so...
Oh, so that makes that easy. Okay. Yeah. So how have things really affected the band then?
Definitely. I mean, just playing shows in general, touring, things like that. A lot of the plans that we kind of had. And then working with people in the industry has just become all over Zoom. Mm-hmm. And so if you have songwriting sessions and stuff like that, you kind of just have to send each other files back and forth while you're both co-writing it. But
right. Have you found that this has kind of forced you guys to write?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah.
A lot of material?
Yeah.
That's great. That's good to know.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're pounding through a lot of new material because that's really pretty much all bands can do right now. It's just kind of write.
And live shows.
And we're hungry to get back out there and play more shows, but definitely want to wait until it's safe and everything. So.
Right, for sure. Well, tell me what it's like releasing your first EP during a pandemic.
Confusing.
Strange.
Yeah, definitely strange. Not what was expected.
Yeah, it's kind of weird, I guess, releasing our, having a release and then not really being able to play it live at all.
Mm-hmm.
That's kind of weird. We're like, all right, now that it's out there, I guess listen to it or whatever. we can't come play them for you. So I guess, I don't know. It's just not how I guess we expected it to go. But
yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
Well, the EP's been out for what, 10-ish days now? 10 days, something around there?
Yeah. Right around
Sounds right.
Yeah.
You guys must be super stoked to have it out.
Oh, yeah.
For sure.
Absolutely.
What was the recording process like? Based on the Ain't That Cool video, it looked like you guys had just the best time ever.
Oh yeah,
we did.
We did. I mean, we have a lot of fun together. No matter what we're doing, like we all are really, really close friends. And so it was. We slept in the studio for a week. We like ate in the studio. We did everything. So we started like you get really tired and start to like lose your mind a little bit. Mm-hmm. And then you drink in the studio sometimes, and then you get like even more lose your mind even more. yeah, it was just like it was just hanging out with some of your best friends for a week, doing something that you're insanely excited to do, and just having a lot of fun with it, trying and exploring, getting creative.
Well, yeah, that definitely came across in like the little clips I could see in the video. Can you tell me a bit about like how the band got together?
Yeah, sure. so it started with me and Sam, and he was playing drums and I was playing guitar, and we were just doing it after work in a bar. And then we met Dylan because he was coming into the bar a lot. No, I'm kidding.
Like every day.
He actually lived right up the road, or this was before that. He lived in a house that could facilitate band practicing there, so we didn't have to wait. We used it for his house. So we didn't have to wait for the bar to close to play music. And so we started playing there, and then started playing shows, met Richard, and he was in a different band at the time, and he joined up with us. And then we needed a keyboardist, so we knew Richard knew piano, because she was in the music community as well around here, and he was like, let's do it. And so she came over and she'd already known, like she like studied the songs and already knew them, how to play them. And we're just like, holy shit. Yeah, you're in. Like, you're wow. Awesome. we're like, cool. You want to play with us? Yeah, that's kind of just how it all formed. And those are the course like years.
But you had a different keyboardist before piano for a couple of years.
Yes. Yeah.
You've had a bunch of different members.
Yeah. Bunch of different members. So piano, what did you bring to the band that you think like elevated or changed things? Put you on the spot. Yeah.
As you take it to the next level. Prove your worth.
I like to play with a lot of synth sounds, so I think I definitely added like a lot of synth elements to the music, I would say.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And she has blue hair sometimes.
Yeah. We needed that.
Yeah,
it needed a little color, a little pop of color.
Right on.
And then those harmonies, of course, too.
It's kind of the other way around. It's more like they like added a lot to my life.
Really. Aww.
Oh. Oh, that's sweet. Where did you record the EP and who were you recording with?
You want to say it?
We recorded it at the studio called 38 North. It's in Falls Church, Virginia.
Cool.
And we recorded it with, our engineer was this guy named Michael Rose. And he's super sick. And
awesome.
Then,
drummer. He's a sick drummer.
Yeah. And then our producers were, I guess, the Party Baby group. I don't know what they go by now.
Yeah.
Their name are Noah Gersh and Jamie Reed, but they're in a band called Party Baby.
Yeah.
Okay. And they're also from LA as well.
Yeah. And so we were lucky enough to have them fly out here and just spent a week cooped up recording.
Cool. Yeah. Did you get to pick who to work with, or was that Fearless is called? Yeah. So why did you want to work with them?
Basically, like the label Fearless Records set us up when we were first signed to meet with different songwriters and producers, and so we took like kind of pretty much a week just to do songwriting sessions with different producers, and every single one of those producers is phenomenal, and they were really awesome people. And I think we went with Noah and Jamie just because I think that what we had made with them and the when we were doing the songwriting session and just kind of how quickly it came together was the direction that we really wanted to take the album in. And we just hit it off immediately personalities wise. We had a lot of fun with them. We still love them. We're still close with them.
Cool. Sorry, I just got a little distracted. I just noticed the dog there right now.
He wanted me when I was petting the whole time.
Were you just rubbing someone's leg? I don't know.
Yeah, I was like, hey.
What's the dog's name?
That's
Hayes. Hayes. Oh, that's awesome.
He's like, what?
Okay, so this might actually be a bit more interesting now that the whole band's here. What track are you most proud of And this could, everyone can answer, but it's going to be different answers for everyone.
Mine,
I can go first. Yeah. Pastels.
Yeah.
Okay.
I love that song. It's always been, if not tied for first, then my first favorite song of the band's.
Oh yeah.
And I love the way it came out on the EP. It's been tweaked a bit over the years. That's one of our oldest tracks. But working with Jamie and Noah, kind of getting their influence on it, I'm crazy about the way it turned out.
Cool.
Proud of, I would say, like, Daydream was super fun.
Yeah.
But Good News is my favorite track on.
Okay.
Rich?
I would say it's a combo of, I feel like Ain't That Cool is the one that I listen to and I'm just like, yeah.
Richard is obsessed with Ain't That Cool.
I'm in this band. And then I'm with Sam on Pastels.
Rhythm Section.
Yeah, it's like the like quick story of like, it's like I feel like I'm rather like, I don't know, any musician is like super self-conscious, but at the same time, it was the first time when I recorded, because we recorded bass and drums together.
Yeah.
And okay. I would say we both have pretty traditional backgrounds of music to where like we killed ourselves with metronomes for
okay.
our upbringing.
Yeah.
And I remember after like first couple takes, like we went back in and they were just like, this is really weird. And I'm like, what do you mean? They're just like, you both are mathematically perfectly on beat.
Oh, cool.
humble flex.
Yeah. But no, it's like,
I don't know.
It was like the first time that I was like, hey, really? And like, I was just like, man, this is really cool.
Yeah.
But I just remember that moment so well.
Ain't
like,
That Cool?
Wow. No, for Pastels.
Oh, for Pastels.
Yeah. And I was just like, wow. I feel really good about this.
Especially
yeah.
coming from like Jamie and Noah and Michael, because like we respect those guys a lot.
Yeah.
So if they give us any compliments, we were always like, oh,
really?
Yeah.
Like I only ever heard my mom be like, you're doing great. And I'm like, thanks, mom. Yeah.
Dale?
I'd say I like Native Tongue, I think, just as like an overall round song because
yeah.
I think it has like a lot of fun different parts and dynamics. I think it's cool that we smashed all that into one song and made it work.
Yeah.
And we got real weird and experimental on it, and it was fun to record.
Yeah.
So I guess, I mean, I'm proud of all the songs on it, but I guess
right.
that's my favorite off the EP.
Okay.
I think Proudest would probably also be Ain't That Cool, only because there's one note that I screamed, and I was like, I hit it really hard, and then after singing it, I was like, it was the first song I sang for. On this EP when we were in the studio and like everybody was listening from I couldn't see everybody, but they were all listening from inside the mixing room. And then I came out and everybody was like, hell yeah. And I was like, okay, thank God. Cause I was like so nervous that it wasn't going to be good enough or that my voice wasn't going to be on point. Everybody was like, it was good. So I would say experience wise, that was my proudest.
Cool. From the EP, you know, seeing as it just came out and no one's allowed to perform, when you are finally allowed to perform in front of a crowd, what is the one you want to play the most?
Native Tongue.
Yeah.
I think Native Tongue. It just goes the hardest in the ends, the
mm-hmm.
hardest. It's just a really, we like really starting with that song a lot because it just hits it like right off the bat. And
cool.
It's just so much fun to play.
Yeah.
Nice.
Also, it's a fun one to play, like, in our hometown of Leesburg, because
it mentions Leesburg, yeah.
And
right.
so it's a really fun one to play here.
Right, right, yeah, in front of the home crowd and all that.
Yeah.
So I want to chat about some music videos for a bit. So my background's in film, so I always like getting the behind-the-scenes stories for music videos or just the thoughts that went into it. So actually, how I found out about you guys was the Daydream music video.
Oh, cool.
Nice.
Well, firstly, when I realized you were signed to Fearless Records, I was like, oh, this is a bit of a different band for Fearless to have on. I'm used to, like, you know, August Burns Red and, like, the heavier
right.
stuff. So I was like, oh, very cool. I think it was also around about the time that the Fearless at Home festival was going on.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So I was kind of going through stuff. I saw the Daydream video, which I thought was really interesting. Because you obviously shot it before everything went to shit, and then it's like a dystopian kind of 1984-esque yeah. vibe to it. Tell me about the idea behind the music video. Who came up with it? How did that get flexed?
So we had a couple ideas going around for that video, but we ultimately landed on this world where, how would you describe it?
So like, it was kind of just like, we wanted to just compare and contrast like a super dystopian, like sterile world where, you know, kind of like a 1984 type thing, or Ray Bradbury in Fahrenheit 451, like mm-hmm. you're not allowed to enjoy things because enjoyment could lead to rebellion and individualism. And then the idea that the main character is daydreaming about a society within that, like, or like a social group within that where he can express those feelings and have fun and be himself and around other people that feel it. And then at the very end, it turns out that he was literally just daydreaming.
Right.
So just kind of like to appreciate what we have when you have freedom and individual, like freedom to think and freedom to express yourself and freedom to be creative and artistic.
We're like, it's our fault. We cursed it.
It's the next week. We're going to predict the future.
So crazy.
I know that there's some references to LSD in the song. Yeah. Does this come from personal experience with the... with LSD?
Yeah.
Okay, wicked. Can you tell me your craziest experience while tripping?
So mine was, I was in Ocean City, Maryland, and it was during the day, and everybody was like, let's go to the beach, and it was during Labor Day. And so on the walk, a couple blocks to the beach, just crossing the highway with the crosswalk sign, I was like, nah, I'm not crossing that. And then my friend's like, come on. So I went out on the beach, and I felt something touch my leg, and I thought it was like, I don't even know what I thought it was. But then I looked down, and there's a baby in a diaper holding on to my leg, and I just was like, no! And this woman comes up, she's like, oh, he's not going to bite you, get away. And I was like, oh, I can't possibly do this. And I just went back to the apartment and just stayed there.
Oh, that's awesome. Cool. Does anyone else have a good acid story, or?
Dylan's got a good one. When you were at the circus show? Yeah, so I took six.
Yeah, that was a lot. yeah, I went to a show up in Pittsburgh with my buddy and found out the importance of fractions. And I found myself in Pittsburgh for the first time, a little bit overwhelmed at a concert. But yeah, it was still fun. And but yeah. I don't
cool.
know. That story could be very long, as everyone here knows. So. Yeah,
right on. Cool. There were some good ones there. Thank you. All right. Then the next one, Ain't That Cool? Again, so I touched on this earlier, but again, this just showed, it was like a beautiful video diary of the making of the EP. I think I just want to talk about like how close you guys are, and it really shows. And it was really nice to see that. It was a feel-good video.
Yeah, that's thank you so much. Yeah, we wanted to kind of just show that off, that like we are as close as we say we are, and we are as goofy as we say we are.
Also, during quarantine, like, it was nice to like look back and be like, man, that was fun.
I know, it was a little bit for us too. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, right. Remember life? Yeah.
Yeah.
And then of course Smile, which came out the day the EP was released. The Beyblade Showdown.
Yeah.
Oh my God. Tell me about that.
We thought of it. We were like, what do? We want to make this song really hit. We want to make a music video. And we were brainstorming. And I was just like, we were just like, what about Beyblades? What if we all just like, we took it really serious, like a training video. And then at the end, it was just Beyblades that we were just prepping up for the whole time. But we did it like the final showdown. We tried to make her look like the guy from Deer Hunter, the guy that
yes oh my God, yeah.
Yeah. so it seemed like way more serious than it was, and that people were spending top dollar to watch Beyblade battles.
It's not so funny because I think that's like one of the more serious sounding songs on the record. And we're like, what if we make this just like at first seem like it's gonna match like the
right.
energy?
It's a great juxtaposition.
The heaviest part to the goofiest shit.
Yeah. Never take anything too seriously.
Yeah. I feel like that was the day where I showed up. I think I was like 30 minutes late, maybe, coming home.
Shocking.
And I like walked downstairs, and they're just like,
we have the concept. And I'm like, I was like, cool, like, what do you think? Just like, Beyblades, you're the trainer, he's the athlete.
That's great. You're like, I love it. Let's do it.
That's perfect.
Oh, that's awesome.
Came into play like 3 days before we made the music. Yeah, like, yeah, we'll do it this weekend.
Oh, cool. All right, so we're coming to the end here for me. I wanted to know what bands or artists you've been listening to the most of during the pandemic. I'm sure we're going to get different ones from everyone, but...
Oh, yeah.
Start Eagles. With yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh, man. I feel like I've been all over the place. I guess the thing that comes first is the new Idols record.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
I've been really listening to that one a lot.
Oh, my God. War is such an insane track. I really love it. Yeah.
It's perfect.
I've been listening to a lot of Cherry Glazer.
Cool.
I've been listening to a lot of this one band, Krungbin.
Yep. Yeah, nice.
Yeah, them, and also a lot of old Mark Ronson.
Okay.
Yeah, like cool. Older, like kind of club mixes are like super sick.
Sweet.
But, yeah.
I've been listening to a lot of Bristol Maroney.
Okay.
A lot of Brother Kenzie. Good bit of the Grateful Dead. And
editing wise, we've all been listening to our own music a lot.
Yeah.
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 A lot of car demos.
Yeah.
Okay. Kinda,
I guess those are all really sad. I should press up happier music.
And how do you generally go about finding new music, like new artists, up and coming artists? And who is the best up and coming artist in your opinion right now?
I'd say Spotify playlists are really great. Also just word of mouth. Like,
yes.
Mm-hmm. Homies. Your friend group. Best up-and-coming artist right now?
Dude, I think...
Bristol Maroney?
Bristol Maroney or Samia? I don't know how to say her name.
Samia is the girlfriend of the...
I think they're dating, I don't know. But that's the dude from Hippocampus and this dude named Normal Parents. I don't know his real name. But the Hippocampus boys just made the record for this artist named Samia. I don't know if I'm saying that right. But that record is fucking awesome and came out, I guess, like 2 or 3 weeks ago. But I've been listening to that, which is also kind of sad.
a happier new artist.
It's like in like the Phoebe Bridgers, Julian Baker kind of make you feel good and bad at the same time. But
yeah, for sure.
She's gonna be pretty big.
Our buddies, the Happy Fits.
The Happy Fits.
They are amazing, and they're going to be huge.
Yeah, they're wonderful people, too. We absolutely love them.
Yeah, they just dropped a record maybe 2 weeks ago.
What's it called again?
Not No Instructions.
What could be better?
Yeah, what could be better?
Cool. Awesome. I think that's pretty much everything for me. Okay, now that I know that you all live together, who's the most annoying roommate?
Pace.
Awesome. Cool, guys. Thank you so much for taking the time.
Thanks, man.
Cool. Cheers, guys. Have a great day. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Bye.